In the previous lecture, we had done the capacitor, the basics. I'll just take it further and explain why energy is lost in charging of capacitor. Now, let me take this system, which is open system. This is the volt of the battery. When I close the switch, I know the capacitor starts charging and plus Q appears here and minus Q appears here. And plus Q and minus Q has appeared because electrons have flown like this. Electrons have come from here, so that is why positive charge keeps on developing here, negative charge keeps on developing here, electric field keeps on developing here. And when the voltage becomes equal, because initially when the capacitor is being charged, the voltage, we know that Q is equal to CV. So the voltage across capacitor is Q upon C. It is not constant, it is varying during charging. So as the charge is increasing, voltage is increasing, and when this voltage becomes equal to this voltage, this flow of electrons, this charging stops, and I have this kind of a situation. Now, first of all, let me find out what is the amount of energy change in the capacitor because of this change in situation. Now, we know that energy change, or we can write in terms of volt and the charge, is V dQ is the change in energy in any system where charge dQ is moving across some voltage V. So effectively, here the voltage is V, which is varying at any given point of time, and let the charge be Q. Plus capital plus Q minus Q are the final charges. These are the final charges. We have to look at the intermediate stage also. So we write like this. This is nothing but change in energy. Or write du, integrated from 1 to 2, initial to final. And also here, initial to final. Now here, we have to see, since when you have such kind of integral, you have to see what are the variables. V is a variable here. So that is why we convert V in such a way that we write it in terms of Q, because it is differentiated with respect to dQ, and V is a variable. Had V been constant, no problem. It would have been V Q2 minus Q1. But that is not the case. V is variable here. So write V as general term, V is Q upon C. So I write it as Q upon C dQ, initial to final. So I get as Q final square minus Q initial square upon twice C is the change in energy of the capacitor. Means U final minus U initial is this much. And initial charge on the capacitor in this case is zero. So U final minus U initial of capacitor is, and Q final is nothing but capital Q, Q square upon twice C. I can write now Q, this Q final is equal to CV. This is the final voltage, this voltage. Now I can write Q final will be equal to CV. So replace this Q final here. I get C square V square upon 2. So it becomes, I replace, so it becomes CV square upon 2. I can also write in terms of potential and charge. So I replace C here. C is Q upon V, so it becomes VQ upon 2 is the change in energy of the capacitor. So it's just a different way of writing it. Now, let us see what has happened to the battery. In such systems, when we say that switch has been closed, means there's a flow of current. Or I can say there is a flow of charge. Here it is very clear, electrons have flown like this. So electrons have flown like this. So current is like this. And charge is also like this. So charge is flowing like this. But this voltage is not varying. I am saying my voltage of battery is constant. And the work, the energy which is lost by the battery, because battery here is doing the work. Battery is supplying energy. It is not coming from anywhere. So energy lost by battery, du of battery, initial energy, final energy, D of battery is V dQ. Same thing I'm writing as I'm writing for the capacitor, but for here the advantage is voltage is constant. So it is V Q2 minus Q1, means the charge which has flown, the charge which has flown, total charge is Q. V Q is the change in energy of the battery, means U final battery minus U initial battery is this. Now we see that this is VQ, but this is VQ upon 2. Where has the energy gone? Let us, I think you know where the energy has gone, but to do such kind of problems, the best thing is take the capacitor and battery as two subsystems. This is one system, this capacitor plus circuit. Any circuit will have resistance. Even if we don't put resistance, there will be resistance in the circuit. And this is battery. These two systems are interacting. For any system, let me take a general system. Any system, we should write the initial energy plus whatever goes into the system. Let Q be the heat going into the system, Q in, and W in is the work being done on the system. Means I am supplying something to the system, so I am raising the energy of the system. So initial energy plus Q in plus W in. Now this will be, total energy cannot be destroyed, system has reached another stage. And this was coming in, system was also giving out some energy and also doing some work. And this was initial stage and it reached to the final stage. So initial plus whatever is going into the system is equal to final plus whatever has gone out of the system. Final energy plus whatever has gone out of the system means these. Initial energy and whatever comes into the system will match with the final energy and whatever has gone out from the system. So it is nothing great, you must be knowing it, plus Q out and W out. This is for any system, generally you write this equation, you keep in mind. Now let me take the battery first. U initial battery, let me write. There is no heat coming into the battery and no heat going out of the battery. Only I am saying the battery is doing some work. This was the work done by the battery, which I took this. VQ was the work done by the battery. VQ was the work done by the battery. No work is coming into the battery. No heat is coming. I am not taking any heat into the battery. So for battery, if I write like this, U initial will be equal to, nothing has come to the battery, U final battery plus the work which was done by the battery. Work battery, and this work battery is nothing but the work which had gone inside here in the other system. I'll come to that. So let this is for the battery. Now for this system, if I write the initial energy of capacitor plus heat coming into the capacitor, let me, I am not supplying any heat to the system, I am not heating it, this is nil for the capacitor. The work coming into the capacitor is same as the work done by the battery. This is the work which is coming out from here, going in here. So it is WB. The work done by battery is work done on the system, will add here for the capacitance, is equal to U final of capacitance plus work done by capacitance is zero. No work is being done. And let some heat, if at all it is there, is Q out. Now just use these systems, I get Q out is equal to WB plus U initial capacitor minus U final capacitor. So I get Q out is equal to WB plus, what is U initial minus U final? Is minus, it is U final minus U initial. So U initial minus U final is how much? Minus VQ upon 2. So write minus VQ upon 2. And what was WB? WB I can find from here. WB was U initial battery minus U final battery, which was this one. WB was this much. I've already found. So I write WB as VQ. So I get Q heat lost is VQ upon 2. So this difference in energy, which was disturbing us, that though the battery was doing this much of work or giving this much of energy, but energy appearing with the capacitor was VQ by 2. So where has that energy gone? It has gone in terms of heat. So half of the energy is lost in heating the capacitor. Half of the energy means a sizable energy is being lost by just, it means when we're just charging the capacitor, heat is being lost. Half of the heat has just gone.